We decided to write this book because we felt that chronological teaching was really not working. And it was important to take that time to restructure our course, particularly in the midst of a global pandemic, as well as a time of racial reckoning in this country. We really wanted our book to be more relevant and our course to be more relevant for students in our course. And we found that we could not find any how-to book out there on the market. As we talked about our approach in our own courses, we felt that as we had conversations with teachers in our area, as well as nationally, that there was a hunger for this type of approach, but a lot of people were stuck with trying to figure out how to do it. So hopefully our book will provide that how-to for teachers, both middle and high school, teaching history of all sorts.
So as Lisa said, we really are hoping that our book is a guide for teachers on how to create their thematic course. And so our book is really structured as that guidebook. So we start with the rationale on why a teacher would want to teach thematically, how that benefits their students, how it increases engagement and relevance, how it allows teachers to center the experiences and the identities of their students. And then we outline what we see as essential ingredients for teaching thematically: engaging through current events, centering identity and inclusion, and using an inquiry-based approach. And we use our own course as a model to guide teachers through the process of building their own thematic course. So we talk about how to come up with a course-long theme, how to create unit themes, and then big picture inquiry questions that correspond to both that course-long and unit-level themes. Then we walk through how to structure a unit, how to create a thematic map starting from the present day, and then tracing the history behind that concept to get back to the present day, answering that question, how did we get to where we are now? Teachers always love lesson plans. It's the heart of what we do. So we walk teachers through how to create a thematic lesson plan, first outlining the elements of a thematic lesson, and then using two of our own as examples. One lesson that covers a broad period of time, over a century, and one that covers a narrow period of time. And then finally, we end with assessments. How do you assess students in a thematic course? Looking at written assessments and project-based assessments.
I would just add that the visuals in the book hopefully are also a win. There's a lot of worksheets, or we call it teaching in action, thematic teaching in action sheets, that hopefully will engage teachers in a really kind of direct, hands-on approach throughout.
And we have lesson planning tools for every step of the process. So lesson planning tools around how to create your thematic concept, your course theme, your unit themes. We have thematic maps for teachers to fill in, our lesson plan template. So lots of lesson resources online. By the end of the book, we're really hoping that teachers have developed the structure for their own thematic course and can kind of hit the ground running.